Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the constructors and methods. So I'm going to discuss the way to set up constructor functions that can help us reuse the constructor to set up more and more objects of the same nature. And I'm also going to set up some methods for the objects and for the constructor functions. Now let me show you the HTML file first. The HTML file is very simple. It just contains a title and a heading. And this file is going to be linked to a JavaScript file called myscript.js, which is stored in the JS folder. And the JS folder is quite simple for now because I have nothing to add. And since I have to use the strict mode, I have to say use strict at the very beginning of the JavaScript file. And then I'm able to show you the content of this topic. When we want to set up a constructor function, we have to understand the reason for that first. The reason for using a constructor function is to help us reuse object generation code. That means when we have a set of code, we can set up different objects that have the same nature by using a constructor function. And we will have a certain keyword called this. The meaning of this keyword is that it refers to the new empty object created using the constructor. This seems a bit abstract, and I'm able to show you an example to demonstrate the meaning of this keyword. Now I'm going to set up a function which will be used as the constructor function. So in general, the function is quite simple. So I have three parameters called name, color, and length. And I'm able to set up an object using this function because I have the this keyword here. The this keyword is going to be linked to the new empty object that will be created using this function. So now I'm going to show you another method to be added to the fruit object. Now I have set up a function that can be used by the object whose type is called fruit. If we want to set up a method for a certain object, I just set up a function in my constructor function to do this purpose. Okay. So this dot name refers to the value passed to the constructor function later on. Same for the this color. And now I have set up a constructor function, and how can I use it to set up an object? I can show you now. The principle is to use the new keyword to create an object. Now I have three arguments to be passed to the fruit function, and I use new fruit to indicate that I have to set up a new object whose reference is called fruit1. Okay, so you can expect that this object has three key value pairs, which means that the name is apple, the color is red, the length is 8 cm, and this fruit object has a certain method called describe. So let me show you the key value pair first. Let me save, and let me reload the page. Save, reload. Yes, you can see that fruit1.color is red because it just refers to the second key value pair inside the constructor function. And how can I call the method for that object? When I say fruit1.describe, it is going to use the describe method for the fruit object type. Save. Reload. Yes, apple in red. So I'm able to show the name of the fruit as well as the color of that fruit by using the describe function, which is inside the constructor function called fruit. So we have to remember to add a pair of round brackets after the method name, because that method name is actually a function. Okay. If we want to add some other methods after setting up the constructor function, can we do so? Yes, we can do so. So we can really add a method for a particular object outside the constructor. So now I set up a certain function called changeColor, and I'm able to pass a parameter called newColor to affect the original color value. So this particular changeColor function is used by foot1 because it is assigned after foot1. So now I'm going to call that function to fruit1, so you can expect that the color of that fruit1 is changed from red to green. Is it really the case? Let me see. Save. Reload. Yes, I'm able to see that the color has changed to green. So a method can be set up outside the object constructor in this way. Okay. In addition, we can add the method using a function. How can I do so? Let me show you now. Now I set up a function which is called changeLength, and I want to pass a new length to the function, and the function is going to change the length of a particular object. So the word this here is referring to the object that uses this function instantly or currently. Okay. Same for this place here. So the this keyword refers to fruit1 because it is fruit1 that calls the key value of pair. Same for here. The object that is going to use this function will be the object that uses the this keyword. So let me show you how to use this function. Now I call the function so that I add a new method to the particular object. So I pass a certain value to the changeLength function for the fruit1 object. So you can expect that the function is set up as a method of an object. Save. Reload. So you can see that the length is now 10 rather than 8 originally. So I can just set up a function and pass it as a method to a certain object. The next topic to talk about is the addition of a method in object literal directly. So I don't always set up a function in the previous way. I can use an object literal to add a method. How can I do so? Now I have a certain object called animal, and the method is set in the object literal directly. So I set a function inside the object literal called eat, and when I want to tell the animal to eat, I'm able to just call the function set up in this approach. Save. Reload. Yes, eating now is coming out. That means we have another way of setting up the function directly by using this particular approach in an object literal. And I have to emphasize that the this keyword in a function is evaluated at runtime. So it just refers to the particular object that uses the particular this keyword. So let me show you an example right now. Now I have two more objects created using the constructor function called fruit. So fruit2 has the this keyword, and fruit3 has also the this keyword according to the constructor function. And we have to notice that that this keyword is not referring to any particular object now, when I have this particular situation like this one. Now I have an external function called decay, and the word this here is not referring to particular object. It refers to the object that it really uses this decay function. So let me show you how I can link the decay function to fruit 2 and fruit 3. So both fruit 2 and fruit 3 would have an additional key called rod, which is just assigned by the decay function, okay? So you can expect that the two fruits would also rot or decay. And how can I show the corresponding methods for the two objects? I can show you now. There are actually two ways of doing so. The first one is to use fruit2.rot. And the other approach is to use a pair of square brackets to contain the property called rod in a string. And we have to remember to add a pair of round brackets at the end to indicate that the rod key is actually referring to a function rather than a certain value. Okay, so let me run it by saving it first. Save. Reload. Yes, for fruit 2, I'm able to see that the banana is decaying. Banana refers to the name of fruit 2. And for fruit 3, I'm still able to call the decay function by using the rot key. And it turns out to be pear is decaying. So the pear is the name of fruit 3. And for this keyword here, it refers to fruit 3. So when I call the decay function by using fruit 3 object, I'm able to link this keyword to fruit 3 so that I can get pear rather than banana. Okay. And I have one more important thing to talk about for this keyword. This keyword in arrow function actually refers to the outer non-arrow function. That means in a certain arrow function, there is no way to use this keyword. Let me show you this example now. Now you can see that I have a very large object and I have an arrow function to represent a certain method called comment. And the arrow function content has this keyword here, but this keyword is not going to be linked to a certain particular object, is that it refers to the object which is just outside the arrow function. So you see the arrow function is set up inside the comment function, and this comment function is surrounded by the movie information. So this keyword would just refer to the movie, okay, but not to the function itself. So how can I show you this way? I can just call the comment method. You can expect that this keyword is going to be linked to the outer non-arrow function, which is just the comment function. Okay. Save. And then I reload the page. Yes, you see that Gone with the Wind is a classic movie. So this keyword is going to link to the outer function, which is having a nature of non-arrow function. So it is important to realize that this keyword is always going to refer to a non-arrow function rather than an arrow function. If you have an arrow function, this keyword is going to link to the outer non-arrow function. So this video has already talked about so many things about object constructors. We know the way to set up a constructor function. We know how to create an object using the new keyword after having a certain constructor function. And we know how to add some methods to the particular object outside the constructor function. And we also know how to realize the role of the dist keyword in different objects. Finally, we know how to handle the dist keyword in an arrow function. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.